greetings. It is interesting to me that on Easter we celebrate the resurrection, but a whole religion called Islam exists to deny the very event. And there is a reason why Islam was created to deny the very event. But first, a little history and facts about the reality of the resurrection. The message of the prophets was clear. Messiah would suffer and die. Daniel 9:24, 70 weeks have been decreed for your people and your holy city, to finish the transgression, to make an end of sin, to make atonement for iniquity, to bring in everlasting righteousness, to seal up vision and prophecy, and to anoint the most holy place. So you are to know and discern that from the issue of a decree to restore and rebuild Jerusalem until Messiah the Prince, there will be 7 weeks and 62 weeks. It will be built again with plaza and moat, even in times of distress. In fact, the timing is known when the command was given by Artaxerxes. And after 62 weeks shall Messiah be cut off, but not for himself. And this means Messiah would die. We know Messiah would be cut off from the land of the living. Isaiah 53:7, he was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that was led to slaughter, and like a sheep that is silent before its shearers, so he did not open his mouth. This was speaking of Messiah and was fulfilled by Yeshua. Matthew 26:62, the high priest stood up and said to him, "Do you not answer? What is it that these men are testifying against you?" But Jesus was silent. And the high priest said unto him, "I adjure you by the living God that you tell us if you are the Christ, the Son of God." Acts 8:32. This is the passage of scripture the eunuch was reading. He was led like a sheep to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. And the eunuch answering said to Philip, "I beseech you concerning whom does the prophet say this, concerning himself or concerning some other?" And Philip, having opened his mouth and having begun from this scripture, proclaimed the good news to him, Jesus. So we know prophet Isaiah foretold Jesus suffering and yet remaining silent before he was cut off from the land of the living, killed. And yet Islam was created to deny and contradict the message of the prophets. Luke 24:5, as the women bowed their faces to the ground in terror, the two men asked them, "Why do you look for the living among the dead?" You see, the women had likely been part of the preparation of Jesus' dead body. The disciples all knew that Jesus was dead. There was no chance of a demonic deception by Al-Makr, the father of lies. "He is not here. He is risen. Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee." The angels remind the followers, "Remember how he told you while he was still in Galilee. The Son of Man must be delivered into hands of sinful men and be crucified, and on the third day rise again." The angels just reminded them what Jesus had told them. So Jesus had already told them that he, Jesus, would die by crucifixion. Luke 24:8, then they, the disciples, remembered his words. If you are a Muslim, you need to wonder why Jesus told them he would die. Jesus told his disciples he would die and rise from the dead. Then they remembered his words. Islam tells a false story that denies the facts of history. And there is a very real reason Islam must try to deny history. God, the Redeemer, had always planned it. Titus 2:14, He gave Himself for us to redeem us from all lawlessness and to purify for Himself a people for His own possession, zealous for good deeds. The Lamb of God was the ultimate sacrifice. John 1:29, The next day John, this is Prophet John, saw Jesus coming toward him and said, Look, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Do you believe in Prophet John? Isaiah 53:10, Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and cause him to suffer. And though the Lord makes his life an offering for sin, if you are a Muslim, you should consider what the will of the Lord means. It was God's will for Messiah to suffer and die. Prophet Isaiah revealed God made his life an offering for sin. Messiah was offered by being killed on the cross. This was the plan, and it was a success, a victory, a triumph. Colossians 2:14, Having blotted out the handwriting in the decrees against us, which was adverse to us, and he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross. Having disarmed the rulers and the authorities, and this is talking about the spiritual authorities, he made a show of them in public, having triumphed over them in it. The cross was not a failure as Satan imagined. In fact, if Satan had known the result, Satan would not have crucified the Messiah. 1 Corinthians 2:7, But we speak God's wisdom in a mystery, the hidden wisdom which God predestined before the ages to our glory. None of the rulers of this world understood it, because if they had, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. So Satan was defeated by the cross and the resurrection. Revelation 1:17, When I saw him, I fell at his feet like a dead man, and he placed his right hand on me, saying, Do not be afraid, I am the first and the last. You see, the Alpha and Omega, the first and the last, is God, and the Living One. And I was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of death and of Hades, or hell. So this is God saying, I was dead. So since God consistently proclaimed the death of Messiah, and Messiah died for many witnesses to see, Satan's only option is to deny history, deny the crucifixion. Satan could not stop the plan of God because Satan does not know God's plan. So Satan created Islam to claim history did not happen. Why would Satan do that? Because God's salvation is offered for all who believe Jesus the Messiah rose from the dead. Romans 10:8, But what does it say? The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith which we are preaching. That if you confess with your mouth Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. The salvation, the promise that God offers you, O Muslim, depends on something. One must believe that God raised Jesus from the dead. If you will believe that, no power in hell can can stop you getting salvation. But if Satan can trick you with a scheme that denies Jesus was raised, then Satan will trick you into abandoning the salvation God has freely offered to you. And that is the very reason Islam was created by Shaitan, or Satan. It sells you a lie that keeps you from really hearing the gospel. Read what the prophets actually wrote, and do not remain a pagan, a believer in Satan's trick religion. It is not your fault Satan has deceived you into his religion, Islam, but it is your choice if you continue to follow his lie. Luke 24:25, "And he," Jesus, "said to them, O foolish and slow of heart to believe in all that the prophets have spoken. Was it not necessary for the Christ to suffer these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was written in all the scriptures about himself." Jesus was not spared and magically disappeared by an all-deceiving Allah. Jesus was crucified and resurrected just as the prophets and the Messiah taught. And today, we celebrate his resurrection that proved Messiah was God in the flesh come to the earth, as the prophets had foretold. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.